United States for your further studies? Got some questions? You're at the right place. Today, we have with us Mr. Arbaaz Hashmi, who will be answering all your questions about MS in US. Hello, Mr. Arbaaz. So what, according to you, is the right time for approaching a bank or an NBFC?
Hi, Priyanka. In my opinion, as soon as you made up your mind that you really want to go for an education in the US, you should start some sort of a communication with the banks. I mean, why is it important is because finance is a very important factor in education in US. And granted that a lot of students want to opt for scholarship before they even consider an education loan, which is totally fine. But what a number of students do not know is that a lot of NBFCs, and specifically for this NMS in US, they can offer education loans without the admission as well. That is pre-admission also. And the student does not have to finalize the education loan till the time he or she has an admit, which gives him totally no responsibility or no accountability to pay anything till they want to finalize the loans. And he's in a situation where he doesn't have to lose anything.
All right. So what is the rate of interest for colleges in USA?
Unfortunately, Priyanka, there is no one answer to it. The ROI does not follow a one-size-fits-all approach. However, there are common factors on which the rate of interest normally depends, which are your scores, which is your 10th, 12th, your graduation, your GRE scores, your TOEFL, your language proficiency test, your college, that we are going to, and the course and specialization. We've had conversations with over about 10,000 students in the past 1 year, actually. And majority of those conversations revolve around making the students aware about their profile, making this from a lender's point of view, that is, or rather their market value, as how our team likes to put it. Speaking in terms of numbers, strictly, for an above average profile, we have gotten the loan sanction at about 10.5% without collateral, that is.
Oh, all right. So let's assume one does provide a collateral. How does that affect the rate of interest?
Priyanka, to answer that question, we need to understand how does a lender evaluate the profiles of students. So fundamentally, there are two things that they evaluate. One is the capability of the student post the course that he or she is planning to go for. And second is the intent to repay back the loan. Okay, for a case in MS in US, the capability part is pretty much covered. The fight is always on the intent. In most of the cases, providing a security upfront would definitely lower the ROI by some margin. However, not everybody can afford to put up their properties for mortgage, and that's why it's a personal choice by the end of it.
I see. So my next question would be, what is the processing time of the loan with and without a collateral?
Priyanka, for an unsecured loan, or like you said, a loan without collateral, it takes up to 5 days to process it. However, on the other hand, if you talk about a loan with collateral, which increases some sort of legal processes and everything, it takes about 10 to 15 days for the entire process.
So let's assume a student has got a loan. So when does the repayment start and what are the modes of repayment?
Priyanka, fortunately, lenders see education in the US and specifically MS as a quite safe option. And hence, the terms like loan tenure, your installments, your moratorium are pretty customer centric. For example, during the course period, the student has to pay only a small fraction of the interest charged on the disbursed amount. For instance, for a loan of 35 lakh rupees, the loan tenure would be about 10 years. For the first 36 months, the student would have to pay the PSI, that is the partial simple interest. And for the next 84 months, he or she would be paying the EMI, and that's when the principal amount kicks in.
To summarize this video, A, the student should talk to the bank as soon as they make up their mind. And B, the rate of interest depends on various factors, like your profile, the college you're going to, or if you have provided a collateral or not. If you have any questions related to masters in US, please post a comment below. Do like and share our video and subscribe to our channel.